Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the class of Unfair Labor Practices. So in our today's class, we are going to discuss about introduction to unfair labor practice. So we should understand what do you mean by unfair labor practice. That is, we will discuss the introduction, the meaning, and also the definitions. And there are unfair labor practices on the part of employer and trade unions of employers. And there are even unfair labor practices on the part of workmen or trade unions of workmen. So today in our class, we are going to discuss about these three things, and workers and unfair labor practices have been a major reason for many disputes, correct? In many organizations, there are unfair labor practices which are being practiced. So one of the best example is again your working time or working hours. If at all, if you are made to work more than 8 hours, that is again unfair labor practice. If you are not paid well according to your hard work, then that is a unfair labor practice. So there are so many practices which are being again followed by both the employers and the employee. And Industrial Dispute Act 1947, amended in 1980. Yes.
The slideshow.
Not visible?
Not visible, sir.
Others?
No, sir. Only these two. Okay.
QSRI. Now?
Now it's okay.
Okay, sir.
Now is it visible?
Yes.
Okay. So Industrial Dispute Act 1947, amended in 1982, specifies what are unfair labor practices. That is on the part of employers and also on the part of employees. So we are going to discuss from the both, that is from the point of laborers and also from the point of employers. The fifth schedule of the act consists of list of unfair labor practices on the part of employers and trade unions of employers, and unfair labor practices on the part of workmen and trade unions of workmen. So now, in maybe in later on slides, I will show you the list of unfair labor practices. First, you understand the meaning, okay? And every employer and workman are entitled to join a trade union and participate in its lawful activities, and anyone who engages in prohibited conduct is said to have committed an unfair labor practice. So what is unfair labor practice? Which is against the law. Okay. Section 2 of the act defines unfair labor practices as any of the practices specified under Schedule 5th of the Act, and it is mainly divided into two categories. What are those categories? The first category, the first part explains about unfair labor practices on the part of employer and the trade unions of employers, and the second one is unfair labor practices of the workmen or trade unions of workmen. And any unfair labor practice with its every notion or with this very notion must have some elements of arbitrariness and unreasonableness. And if unfair labor practices is established, the same would be violating equality under Act, under Article 14 of the Constitution of India. Mr. Adam Sharif, this is according to our Indian law. Okay.
Yeah. I can understand.
But there are some commonalities. Whatever labor, whatever unfair practices you find here, maybe same in your country also. Maybe the law and articles or the acts may be different, but all these unfair labor practices are common towards the common worldwide. Okay. Now we will understand unfair labor practices on the part of employer and trade unions of employers. So now we are speaking from the point of employer. The unfair labor practices prohibited with respect to employer and trade union of employer as follows. The first one is interfere with workmen to restrain from in the exercise of employer right to form, organize, join or assist a trade union to engage in concerted activities for the purposes of collective bargaining or other mutual protection or aid in cases of, the first one is threatening workmen with dismissal or discharge if they join trade unions. My dear students, the first point speaks about the unfair trade practices followed by the employer. Nothing but threatening the employees that not to join any trade unions. Is it clear? Are any activities which are again failing to encourage the collective bargaining, that is again unfair trade practices, and threatening a lockout if trade union is if a trade union is organized. Lockout, what do you mean by lockout?
Exit.
Yes.
Exit.
Exit. Okay. So if you are threatening your workmen not to join any trade union, it is unfair practice. If at all, if you are threatening your employees with a lockout, is nothing but the employer shutting down the organization or shutting down the production process or stopping the production process, that is called as lockout. And the third one is granting wage increase to workmen at crucial period in order to determine the attempts of trade union. If at all, if you are not allowing them to grow. Next one is interfere with, dominate or contribute support financially or otherwise to any trade union of employer in case of, the first one is an employer actively interested in organizing a trade union of his workmen. The second point is an employer doing partiality or favoritism to one of the several trade unions, attempting to organize workmen to its employers where such is not recognized trade union. Next one is establish sponsorship for employer to trade unions of workmen. The next one is encourage or discourage membership in any trade union by discrimination against any workman, such as discharging or punishing a workman if he urges another workman to join the trade union. So generally we all are aware that people working together, they make all these things. So they urge the different people to join the trade unions. If at all, if you are discharging them, if at all, if you are not allowing them, or if at all, if you are threatening them that you will punish if you request your co-employees to join the trade union, that is also a unfair labor practice. Discharging or dismissing a workman if he takes part in any strike, so that is also a unfair labor practice. Changing seniority classifications of workmen because of trade union activities. If at all, if you are not considering the seniority, or if at all, if you are changing the classification, then that is also called as unfair labor practice. Next one is a denial of promotion of workmen to higher posts because of their trade union activities. If you are not promoting them, that is because of the trade union activities, that is again the unfair labor practice. Giving promotions without merit to certain workmen with a view to create a dispute amongst other workmen or to show the strength of the trade union, that is also an unfair practice. Discharging active members or office bearers of the trade union on account of their union's activities. See, generally people are not responsible for the activities of trade unions, right? But because of trade unions, if at all, if you are threatening them, that would be considered as unfair practice. Discharge or dismiss workmen, that is to say, by the method of victimization, not in good faith, but in the credible exercise of the employer's rights. So we can use our rights to remove the employee. So that is also unfair practice. By falsely accusing a workman in a criminal case or on false evidence for the patently untrue reasons, on false allegation of absence without leave, in absolute discard or disregard of the principle on natural justice in the conduct of domestic enquiry, disproportionate punishment for minor misconduct or technical issue without having information to the nature of particular misconduct or past record of service of the workman. If they are not aware about the technical issues, if they come across any problems, you are not supposed to punish them because they are not aware about it, aware about those technicalities. As a measure of breaking a strike, the work of a regular nature being done by workmen is abolished and give such work to contractors. Now you are outsourcing the things to the contractors. Under the guise of the following management policy, transfer of workmen from one place to another. So that is also unfair labor practices. Insist individual workmen who are on legal strike to sign a good conduct bond as per precondition for the allowing them to resume work. So when they are on strike, if at all, if you are imposing or if you are insisting or forcing them to work, so that is an unfair practice. Regardless of merit, to show favoritism or partiality to one set of workers, that is also unfair practice. Whether you all are there with me?
Yes, sir.
I hope you all are understanding, right? These all are self-understandable sentences, correct?
Yes.
To employ workmen casually or temporarily as budlis and continue them for years with the motive of depriving them of the privileges of permanent workers. You are only encouraging them or you are only allowing them to work as a temporary only. You are not making them as, or you are not giving the privilege of permanent worker. Discriminate against any workman for filing charges or testifying against an employer in an investigation. If you are testifying against the employer, then you are not supposed to discriminate. You are not supposed to remove them. And recruit workmen during a strike which is not an illegal strike. So now you should not also recruit workmen during a strike which is not an illegal strike. And failure to settlement or agreement, implement an award. If at all, if you are not awarding them, if at all, if you are not recognizing them, that is also an unfair labor practice. Indulge in violence and any act of force is an also unfair practice. Refuse to bargain collectively in good faith with recognized trade union. So now you are not ready to bargain. That is also an unfair practice. Continuation of lockout deemed to be illegal under this act. So now if at all, if you're continuingly shutting down the production process, so that is also called as an unfair labor practice. So these are some of the practices from the point of employer. Is it clear? You all understood at least some points about the unfair practices followed by the employer on the part of employer? Yes. Now we are going to discuss unfair labor practices on the part of workmen or trade unions of workmen. The first one, the unfair labor practices prohibited with respect to workmen and trade union of workmen are as follows. The first one is advise or actively or instigate or support any strike deemed to be illegal under the act. If being a workman, being an employee or a laborer, if you are taking part in a strike which is illegal, then it is called as unfair practice from the point of workmen. Okay, restrain workmen in the exercise of the right to join a trade union or refrain from or self-organization in cases of, or if the second point speaks about restraining a workman, that is in exercise of their right to join the trade union, being a workman or being a labor, if you are compelling other laborers not to join, restraining other workmen not to join the labor units, that is called as unfair practice. The next one is trade unions to be picketing in such a manner that non-striking workmen are physically debarred from the entering the workplaces. So now here, if at all, if you are not in a strike, so you are not supposed to debar or you are not supposed to remove the employees who are not sitting on strike, indulge in acts of violence or hold out threats of intimidation in connection with strike against non-striking workmen. If there are people who are not participating in non-strike or in strike, you are not supposed to threaten them or you are not supposed to indulge in acts of violence. Okay, recognized union refused to bargain collectively in good faith with the employer. If at all, if you are restraining or refusing not to bargain collectively, that is with the good faith or with the employer. Next one is indulge in coercive activities against certifications of a bargaining representatives. Coercive is nothing but forcefully. So you are not supposed to indulge in coercive activities against the certification of bargaining representatives. So generally we all are aware that the company representative comes to sit and discuss, that is to sit and bargain and negotiate, and you are not supposed to indulge in any forceful or force activities which will threaten the representatives. The next one is encourage or instigate forms of coercive actions as willful, go slow, squatting on the work premises after working hours, or girav of any member of managerial staff or other staff. Now you should not force any of the employees. Either you can be a managerial employee staff or a non-managerial staff or other staff, and stage demonstrations at the residence of employers. Excuse me. Indulge in any willful damage to the employer's property related with the industry. So now you are not supposed to destroy any of the property which is relating to the industry and to the owner. Indulge in any act of violence or force or hold out threats against the workman with a view to prevent him from attending the work. So now you are not supposed to threat anyone that not to attend the works or not to attend his or her job. So these are some of the unfair trade practices from the point of employer and also from the point of employee. Is it clear, my dear students?